tell me everything you know. Let's kick things off with a good old-fashioned question. What are some of the lesser-known powerful things that Firefox can do? Ooh-wee, I've been waiting all week for this one, boy hottie. I finally get to tell you about
Hey, Shanae, there's been a change and not you.
What? What do you mean, not you? Are you trying to tell me we're doing another Firefox Academy? But it's in my contract. Wait a minute, you can't do this! Hello, students, I'm your professor, Dr. Nay. Before our first feature, I'd like to propose a question to all of you. If you were to open a Facebook tab right now, how many trackers would you find scooping your data like ice cream from your profile? If only there was some way to know. But that's just it. There is a way, and of course, it's built right into Firefox. Open your browsers and browse to one of your favorite sites. If you take a look just to the left of your URL bar, you'll notice a shield. Click that shield and you'll find the protections dashboard. Sort of like this. This dashboard holds very important information about how Firefox has automatically defended you from three major privacy threats. Cookies. Fingerprints. Are those actual fingers? And trackers. This automatic blocking happens whether you've opened the dashboard or not. But now you can see when your data is being tracked while you browse, so you can start making educated choices about your browsing habits. Onward to the next feature. Allow me to paint a scenario for you. You're lounging on your daybed, browsing recipes on your phone to send to your personal chef for dinner tonight. Very relatable, I know. You found 17 mouth-watering recipes and want your chef to make them all. Why should you choose one? That's where Pocket steps in. It's a save button for the internet. Using the Pocket mobile app, you can stash those recipes directly into your Pocket. Now over on your desktop, just hit the Pocket button, select View My List, and there you'll find all your saved articles. The features don't stop there. Pocket also has a discovery page, and while it is curated partly by an algorithm, it is done so in conjunction with real human eyes and hands. Let's examine a new scenario. You're taking an online class with an extremely compelling professor. You prefer to watch the course on your iPad, but you couldn't be bothered to copy that link and send it to yourself. Don't send it, sync it. Tab Sync makes your active desktop tabs accessible on your mobile devices and vice versa. Sounds like you need another visual example. Take this muffin, for instance. As you can see, this muffin is muffin number one. We see that it's 6 p.m. and we gotta go home. But to leave our desk would mean we gotta smash this muffin. Boom shakalaka! Lucky for us, Tab Sync has taken all the contents of muffin one and allowed us to once again enjoy the presence of muffin number one in our pocket. Ta-da! That brings us to our final feature of today's lecture, tab resurrection. Now normally for a resurrection, you would need 2 tablespoons of salt, blessed by a priest, or a salt bay, 2 ounces of holy water, and a young priest and an old priest. However, both priests were unavailable today, so instead we'll be using Firefox's built-in tab resurrection feature. If you've accidentally closed your Firefox window and need to get back to what you were doing quickly, you can push the restore session button in the history settings to bring the session back from the dead. You can even tell Firefox to do this every time you open the application, so you never have to remember all your go-to URLs ever again. Oh yeah, and no salt bait necessary. That concludes Firefox 102. Wish to know more? Drop your questions in the comments or find us on Twitter and Instagram @Firefox. As always, I'm your girl Shanae, and I hope to see you on the flip side.